It took some going back and forth, but we're finally getting the pipe operator in PHP 8.5. In this video, we'll take a look at how it works, but also why you want to use it. Imagine some kind of input, a string, for example, and you want to perform a series of operations on it. Let's say you want to transform that string into a slug. You can probably think of a handful of other examples from your own code, and there are a number of problems with it. First, deeply nested function calls can spiral out of control fairly quickly. Second, code formatting becomes a mess when you have to decide if you want each new argument on a new line or only have a new line per function call. And third, this code must be read reversed from the inside out. It starts with trim, then moves to string replace, and so on. A possible improvement would be to introduce a temporary variable. And I would say this is already a lot better. But the downside is that we introduce a new temporary variable. It feels icky. It's not a deal breaker, and it's definitely better than deeply nested function calls, but what if we could make it just a tiny bit more convenient? That's what the pipe operator is for. This is what that same code looks like in PHP 8.5. And that's looking pretty good. Now, there are a couple of side notes to make, so let's take a closer look. So the pipe operator works by piping whatever is on the left side to the right side. And the left side is pretty simple to understand. Any kind of input can go here. Strings, arrays, object, the output of a previous pipe. But what about the right side? And this is where you need to take a couple of things into account. The first possibility is passing in a reference to a callable, a so-called first class callable. However, this option only works if setCallable only takes one argument, which will be the input provided to the pipe. In other words, this code will be transformed behind the scenes into this. But what if you want to pass the input to a function that takes multiple arguments? This is when you need to use a callable. These callables can be short or full closures, invocable classes. They can even be string or array references to callable functions, as long as they only take one input argument. Personally, I prefer to use short closures, but the fact that you need to introduce this extra layer of callables, it does feel a little clunky, I would say. It's even more verbose than the temp example I showed earlier. However, I still prefer using the pipe operator over temp variables because a block of pipes feels more like code that belongs together than when you'd use a temporary variable. And you know, internals are actually working on a follow-up feature that would play very well together with the pipe operator. It's called partial function application, and it would allow us to write the previous example like so. Do you notice that question mark? That's a placeholder for missing input, and that's the gap the pipe operator could fill in when it arrives at this function. It would be really nice to combine the two. But for now, we'll have to make do with using callables. Now, despite that shortcoming, I really like the pipe operator. I think it's an amazing feature, and I'm so looking forward to using PHP 8.5. So what are your thoughts? Let me know in the comments, and you can also join our Discord server. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to stay in touch. So see you in the next video.